Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Madeline, this is Made with Books, and welcome to Cozy Reading Night. Cozy Reading Night is hosted by Lauren from Lauren and the Books. I will link her channel down below. She does it, I think, at least 4 times a year with the seasons, and then sometimes Christmas ones or things like that. And actually, Dan and I had been planning a Cozy Reading Night for tonight anyway, and I somehow missed Lauren's announcement video. But then I saw Kelly from Books I'm Not Reading, whose channel I will also link down below, mention that she and Jason are planning to do a Cozy Reading Night tonight, because it is. And so we figured that works out kind of perfectly, and so I decided we're gonna try to vlog it a little bit. And yeah, I'm just gonna take the camera away from Daniel now and ask him what he wants to read. Okay, focus on you.
Oh, okay, I was planning to read Middlemarch, the famous Victorian classic by George Eliot, because I have been reading that for a couple of months now and somehow always got distracted from it by starting other books. But I just got, as you maybe can see, really just 60 or 70 pages left till I'm done, so I hope that I can make some progress on that tonight. And then another giant book that I've been carrying around with me for quite a while now is the Oxford Book of Essays, edited by John Gross. Gross? I'm not really sure.
Hope he's not gross.
Let's hope it's gross and not gross. And same here, don't really have much left to go. Actually, it's less than what you see, because some of the essays that are still coming I did already read, so yes, the book is in a chronological order, so all essays that I still have to read are from the 20th century.
Fits kind of perfectly for Nonfiction November as well.
Right, yeah. True, yeah, perfect. I didn't plan it that way, but yeah. I'm a bit too late for Victoria with that one, but I mean...
Oh yeah, show them how torn our Middlemarch edition is. It's kind of damaged.
Let's hope I can finish it without...
I already read it, so I think I did some of the damage, but then you ripped one of the pages, didn't you?
The very first one, yeah, that makes it very, very special here.
Promise we love our books, even if it doesn't look like it.
Yeah. The weird thing is the exact same thing happened to another book that I was carrying.
Shh, don't tell them!
Okay. Somehow it just seems that something in my bag, maybe there's a book monster living in my bag that tears the first page apart.
Sounds gruesome. Okay, I'm gonna pass the camera back to you and show the books I want to read.
Okay.
I had to take off my sweater, my cozy sweater, because as much as this is Cozy Reading Night, it was getting too warm. This room is usually really cold, so I don't know what's going on. I have a couple of options. I definitely will read Der Ursprung der Welt by Liv Strömquist. This translates, I guess, to The Origin of the World by Liv Strömquist. And if you can gather by the cover, it's all about the vulva. And so it's sort of a history of that. It's a graphic novel. I already started this, I was naughty and started it in Victober, even though I was going to read it for Nonfiction November. But I couldn't stop myself, and I'm already a big part in. I think I'm on like page 109, so I only have a little bit left, so I think I will finish this and yeah, report back. I'm really enjoying it so far, it's really interesting. And sticking with the feminist nonfiction, I also have Margarete Stokowski's Untenrum Frei. This also kind of works for German Literature Month, I guess, because Margarete Stokowski is German. She's a feminist, and she writes for Spiegel, which is one of the big German magazines. She has an editorial with that magazine on all kinds of political issues, not only on feminism, but this one is very much how the way that we deal with our body is related to the political aspects. Now, I don't think this one has been translated into English. I'm not sure with this one, but if it has been, I will link it down below. This one, by the way, is also translated from the Swedish into German, so, and it has been translated by, should have researched that beforehand, it has been translated by Katharina Erben. And then I just have some other options, I guess. I don't know, I'd probably be mostly occupied with those since it's nonfiction November, but I still have a few books I carried over from Victober. One is As Kingfishers Catch Fire by Gerard Manley Hopkins. This is Victorian poetry, and I still have like 20 pages of this. I mean, it's tiny, but the poetry is very dense, so I have to reread them a couple of times and sometimes look up analyses online. So yeah, those are our options. I think I'm gonna start with the graphic novel in the first hour, and it's already past 7, so we're already lost some of the time, but we're just probably gonna tag it on at the end. And before we actually start reading, we're gonna have supper. I was gonna film close up with the pizza, but then I realized a lot of steam and the camera together doesn't go very well together. So we have this pizza, and that doesn't look very appetizing, but we have some browned onions and some leftovers from our lunch, which was vegan sausages and some sauce and some potatoes. And yeah, we're just gonna eat that for now, and then afterwards start reading. We also have some sustenance for the cozy reading night, some tea. This is just peppermint tea. This is my Wisconsin mug. I've spent a year in Wisconsin, and I got this from my host family afterwards, actually. It's a Starbucks mug, and there's Daniel's mug. Just a boring gray one. We have some chocolate cookies in heart-shaped chocolate cookies. Some waffles. These are really nice. And I have some chocolate cream, which I will just eat with my spoon because I'm that kind of person. And we have some popcorn, but this is optional. We'll see how it goes. And yeah, tried to create some ambience with candles. I don't know if you can see that. There's some more candles. Oh, there's a plant inside, by the way, which usually is outside, but because we are finally hitting the minus degrees in Celsius, we had to take it inside. We haven't found a proper spot for it yet. But... and yep, some more candles on the piano. I don't really play it, Daniel does. I've taught myself some like simple songs with the help of Daniel, mostly children's songs, so yeah. But yeah, I think we're all good to go. So it's been an hour, and we're just doing a check-in. Daniel, how's the reading been going for you?
Yeah, I've read a couple of pages of Middlemarch. Not too much, to be honest. I'm getting a bit tired, so...
First hour already,
yeah,
giving up.
I know, it's still quite early, but I'm a bit tired. But I've made some progress, and I'm hoping to read a couple of pages more. And then maybe one or two essays later on. So, what's your progress?
I finished The Origin of the World by Liv Strömquist. And yes, I really liked this. This was a birthday gift from two friends. And it was really interesting. I learned a lot. I actually have to shamefully admit I didn't know the difference between vagina and vulva. This explains it. So this was interesting, and then it has sort of a lot of historical background on female physiology, on the vulva specifically, on menstruation. So yeah, it was really an interesting read. And then I did read two poems by Gerard Manley Hopkins. I'm up to his later poetry, and I think they're called the Desolation Poems or something like that, because he was probably suffering from, I think now they think it might have been some sort of bipolar disorder, but also like depression maybe. And you can tell in these poems, so they're not exactly a fun reading. And I've read a little bit from his Hopkins journals, which just seems to be nature observations. And I thought these would be sort of easier to be read, but the language is very dense as well, so I've only read two pages of that. And then I just started to read Margarete Stokowski again. I'm already read the first two chapters before this night started, and I just started chapter 3, Knowledge is Power. So yeah, that's what I've been up to. Okay, I guess we'll check back in an hour. See you then, guys. So I've just decided I'm gonna make this popcorn. Okay, not sure how I can do that with the camera in my hand, so I'm just gonna stop filming for a second and you're gonna see the popcorn in the microwave in a moment. Okay, it's 10:30 in the evening and we're gonna wrap up our cozy reading night. We started in a half hour late, so we're finishing half an hour late. Thank you to Loan from Loan and the Books for hosting this, and yeah, I think we had a fun night. Daniel, do you want to say what you've been reading?
Yeah, sure. Well, I've been reading, as I said, Middlemarch, made some progress with that. Read a couple of dozen pages, and I started. So it's late. I'm tired. I didn't start this book, but I started an essay in there. I didn't get to finish it because I was getting too tired.
Which one was it?
It's called The Snout by Lauren Isley.
Oh, okay.
Very biological essay, but it's interesting, about the origins of humanity. Something that I usually don't know too much about. And yeah, I hadn't picked up this book in, I think, almost a year, so...
About really, time.
Yeah, and also thanks to the cozy reading night, I did that. I think otherwise I wouldn't have picked it up for another year or so. So, yeah, that was good.
Okay, so like I said, I was reading Margarete Stokowski und Norm Frei, which... I guess roughly translates to free down there. The chapter I was reading was chapter 3, and the way it works, she said they could be read as sort of individual essays. And this one, I said it was called Knowledge is Power. It's technically, if you translate it, it's knowledge would be power. So it's about the lack of knowledge that teenagers have growing up about sexuality, about consent, and other things, and it also deals with some very personal experiences she had, and actually a rape situation. So, but she points out that there's some issues like rape and self-harm in the book. She points out at the very beginning of the book which pages those are, which I think is really good. So if that triggers you, you can skip them. So I think that's good. But yeah, this was... really good. Certain parts I obviously didn't enjoy, but it was still very interesting to read. And then I read another Manly Hopkins poem, still continuing with the sort of bleak theme. And I also continued with the extract from his journal, and he traveled into, I think it's the Swiss mountains. So sort of landscape descriptions, a lot of that about nature. So yeah, that's been our cozy reading night. Thank you guys so much for watching, and Daniel and I, or only me, will see you next time. Bye guys!
Oh, also, we destroyed the popcorn.